Right, this is the website that you're going to come to when you click on assignment 6.2. We've already been to this website in assignment 6.1, so we can skip the intro. The assignment is going to come here from this up to 180 degrees in ones. That is the lesson that we're going to be going through. So we'll click on that. Notice you'll have your protractor. The directions, let's start measuring. You need to be accurate to 1 degree. Look carefully. Up to 180 degrees in ones. So this is the lesson that we're on. Take your protractor, click on it with the left mouse button, move the crosshairs there to the vertex of the angle first, and then use the buttons along the bottom to turn your protractor to get your 0 degree mark lined up. So I can move left or right by however many degrees, 1, 5, or 20. And I just continue moving until I get that 0 degree lined up along the edge of the angle. Now I've done that. It is the outside zero that is lined up, so I'm going to use that to measure my angle, that outside scale. So I'm going here using the outside. Looks to be about 136, 137, somewhere right in there. I'm just going to say 136 and see what happens. Tells me I got zero correct after one attempt. It's too low. Look again. So it tells me up at the top that I've had one attempt, zero correct. It tells me down here at the bottom that it's too low. So let me try 137. Still too low. Let me try 138. Well done. Okay, now you'll understand that this is not a real accurate protractor. You're going to be able to look at it and get pretty close. Sometimes it might take you two or three times just to get it correct, and that's okay. I'm not grading your attempts. I'm grading your number correct. I want you to do this until you get 7 correct. You can do 8 if you want and get an extra credit point for doing 8 of them, but you need to do at least 7 of these to get a perfect paper. You can submit, if you only get 1 correct and you want to submit and get 1 out of 7, that's up to you, I guess. But I would suggest just continue going through these until you can get yourself a 7 out of 7. So again, we'll put your crosshairs of the protractor at the vertex of the angle, and then turn your protractor until you get a 0 degree mark lined up. It doesn't matter which 0 degree gets lined up. Here I'm using the inside 0 degree, so I'm going to use the inside set of numbers to measure my angle. Looks to be about 122 or 123 degrees. I'll try 123. Got it correct. And then I go to the next angle and do the same thing. When you are done, you're going to have to take a screenshot, and there's a video that shows you how to take a screenshot if you don't know how to do that. Then you'll come to your Dropbox and submit your picture into this Dropbox here for assignment 6.2. I know it's a lot of steps for taking the screenshot and that, but there's no other way that we can do this for measuring angles. If you're having problems getting your screenshot taken care of, please contact me and I'll help you through it. Good luck with things, and we will talk to you later.